You click this video because you're either a seasoned YouTuber or an aspiring YouTuber and you're wondering if paying $300 for Davinci Resolve Studios is actually worth it or a complete waste of money. Well, if you're looking for the short answer, I bought Davinci Resolve Studios. I've been using it for a while and I can totally say that it's worth every penny of your hard-earned money. If you want the longer answer to hear about the different Davinci Resolve Studios features that you're going to be getting that you'll actually care about, then stick around. You're in for a wild ride. By the way, if you're wondering why this is here because I want to show you one of the best and most fun features that you get with Davinci Resolve Studios. I'm gonna make this disappear right now. See, wasn't that cool? All right, now I really need to get this out of the way because it's actually bothering me. All right, so first things first, let's talk about the price and what exactly you get when you buy Davinci Resolve Studios. So when you buy Davinci Resolve Studios, you're not only getting the activation key, but you're also getting a free thing called a speed editor. And honestly, not gonna lie, I'm all about the free stuff. When you go to buy both of these separately, they're both $300 a piece, so this is really a $600 value that you're getting for $300. So what the speed editor actually is just one big macro device made for specifically DaVinci Resolve. So with the activation key, one thing you gotta keep in mind is you only get two activations with this, so definitely don't lose that crap. Or if you wanted to, you can have DaVinci Resolve on two different computers or the price of one. Also, something that's different than other editing softwares is the fact that you only need to pay for DaVinci Resolve just one time. So unlike other editing software, you don't have to actually pay any additional money for any updates that Blackmagic decides to do for DaVinci Resolve. The next one's a really big one, and DaVinci Resolve Studios actually comes with hardware encoding. Hardware encoding actually allows DaVinci Resolve to use your GPU to encode some of the things going on within the software, which of course a lot of you are probably used to seeing this with other programs, more specifically with your live streams with using NVENC encoding through your NVIDIA GPU. That's one of the best parts about having an NVIDIA graphics card is they're always trying to optimize their hardware encoding and work with companies like Blackmagic to help utilize it within their software. What you're seeing right now is footage from the free version of DaVinci Resolve. You can see how slow and how much of a delay there is when scrubbing to the timeline. You can also see how long it's taken for things to load in. Here it is with the studio version. You can already see how smooth and quick it is to scrub the timeline and how fast everything loads in once you stop. Also, this helps with things like loading the fusion page faster, loading complicated transitions instantly, and also rendering your videos at least 50% faster. Number three is something called lens correction. DaVinci Resolve Studio includes a lens correction feature that allows you to analyze a clip and correct the lens distortion or other aberrations. It uses advanced image analysis to process algorithms for incredibly high quality results. In English terms, basically if you use a super wide lens, you'll get this weird fishbowl effect whenever you import your footage. What this lens correction thing does is just flattens out your image and makes it look normal. Next thing is something called noise reduction. DaVinci Resolve Studio includes some of the most sophisticated noise reduction tools in the world. Temporal and spatial noise reduction tools can be used independently or together to help clean up and remove unwanted noise in virtually any image. Once again, in English, if you have a lot of graininess in your image, maybe your camera's not as strong, or even if you're using a webcam, what this can do is actually clean up some of the graininess and make it look a little bit more sharp. So the next thing you get is something called the DaVinci Neural Engine. You actually get a lot of things to this, from facial recognition or something called speed warp and object isolation, to things like object removal. I mean, is the coat rack still here? And something really cool called super scaling. All right, just to do object removal again, because I actually want to, since we're talking about it, I'm gonna make this cup disappear and boom. That's awesome, man. So super scaling is actually pretty cool. What this allows you to do is take any low resolution footage and actually upgrade it to any resolution that you would like. So for the rest of the key features, we're just gonna shotgun them out in a little rapid fire list. You can actually render out an H.265, which compresses your files even smaller while maintaining the same image quality. You have a ton more format exporting options when you're going to render your video. You can import footage up to 32K, 120 frames per second. You can do something called remote rendering. You can actually have another computer render a project that's within the same network. The whole Resolve effects suite is open to you. In fact, you get 30 new effects. So ultimately, I'm gonna ask the question again, is DaVinci Resolve worth $300? Once again, I think yes, but this really depends on where you are in your YouTube journey. For me, it was an absolute must. I couldn't stand how slow DaVinci Resolve was running, as well as some of the little things that would break. I haven't had any of those issues anymore when I've been using DaVinci Resolve Studio. And the biggest reason why is because hardware acceleration is just so amazing. I'm definitely a believer that if you're really passionate about growing on YouTube, you need to invest invest in the tools that are actually going to help you make stuff a little bit easier. For example, there's obvious things like cameras and microphones, maybe even a more powerful PC. But one thing a lot of people forget about is having the right type of software, more specifically editing software. Most of the other editing softwares have some sort of gimmick. Either you have to pay monthly to use their service, or if you buy it once, you got to buy the license again when they do any updates. And if I'm being totally honest, the free version of DaVinci Resolve really does have everything you need to get started with creating YouTube videos. And honestly, I haven't really mentioned much about this little speed editor, but really so far from the very little things I've done with it, I really like this thing. If you found this video helpful, I have other videos on my channel going over more of the technical stuff when it comes to making YouTube videos. More specifically, you'll find this video right here super helpful. It's where I re-edited my best video and found 6 editing mistakes that most people make in their videos and how to actually avoid them. But anyways, guys, thank you so much and we'll see you next time.